We're up there, right now, we're working on 544 solar modules we're putting in now for the Keweenaw Bay Indian community. And we're doing a lot of LED lighting for our commercial and industrial businesses around Houghton, Hancock, and Keweenaw. Well, what we do is, a customer will call us and ask what we can do for them, and we work with the state of Michigan to get all the rebates and money we can for them. And we go in, like McGann's we've done, Swift's has been done, Northwood's has done, and we'll give them a proposal, and we'll calculate how much money they're gonna get from the state, and take that off the top, give them a very reasonable price. And I've done a lot of research on getting hardware for LED lighting for them, so I get really good prices. I also worked with the state to get LED lighting prices down. So we're trying to convert a lot of residences and businesses around here to all LED lighting. It's one of the most effective and fastest ways you can reduce your power bill and reduce your carbon footprint. Now, right now, on solar, there's a lot of transition going on with the legislation for a couple of bills down in Lansing. They have not been voted on. It's the next generation of energy policy for Michigan, and includes net metering. If you don't know what net metering is, it's when you put on a bunch of solar panels, you can hook it to the grid, and you used to get paid one-to-one retail rate for what you produce in excess of what you use. So that is not the case anymore. UPCO has canceled their interconnections for residential. That's a class one system below 20 kilowatts. Class twos are still being interconnected, and we're doing some embargo right now. But the other thing that's going on with that, the legislation down in Lansing is gonna be voted. Hopefully, they're gonna deal with this in January and figure out what they're gonna pay for an interconnection amount when they redo the net metering. But right now, UPCO does not have any net metering. Residential solar is not available unless you want to go on your own. And that's something else we're gonna do next year. I'm gonna get 5 people, and we're gonna go for a grid defection. Grid defection is it called. You put in a battery system, you put in a backup generator when the sun's not shining, and you throw your solar on, they'll UPCO get their lines off your house. And they work fine, they just aren't that cost effective. A lot of people are interested in that stuff. So we're gonna do that next year, and hopefully this solar stuff comes around, Lansing in our favor, but I'm not real hopeful on it. How do we get this slide? LED lighting is, as you know, Melissa, she gets some very good prices on that. She's doing a lot of residential work, and we do a lot of commercial, but the benefits of LEDs are just tremendous. The lighting is really good. It's on, very energy efficient, no mercury in them, so we don't have to go to a hazardous waste disposal unit to dispose of them. You just throw them in the garbage or recycle them at electronics recycling place. They have no ballast. And all these fluorescent lights, you have a ballast that drives the LED lights. That is no longer needed. And on some of the older T12 with the magnetic ballast, you'll see those spiral and you'll hear the hum on there. A lot of people say those give you headaches, and LEDs won't do that. So the actual environment's improved, and the energy efficiency is tremendous on it. That's a 60-watt equivalent bulb right there. You see, for 9 watts, I think it is. 9 watts versus 60. So you can see there's a tremendous amount of savings on it.